Here's a project that you could use your garter bar to make some garter stitch. It's actually a baby booty. I did cast on 38 stitches. I knitted 2 rows, and then from there I started turning after each row. So I need to make sure that my latches are open. And then you're going to take your garter bar and you're going to have these indents up, or if you have the new Chris Crafter style, it doesn't really matter, but the old-fashioned ones. Now I like to put the end needle right here on the end, and I go down on one side. I start on one side and then I lay it down, as you see. Then I take and pull the material onto the garter bar, sometimes pushing it, making sure these loops go all the way down on the prongs. Then I bring the garter bar down and go back just a little bit to close those open the latches. I pull the yarn out of the carriage. I also have my left Russell lever out to number 1. So it's not going to push those needles back. And then now I'm going to get the hook of the needles right here below the yarn. Now you see, as I turn it around, the extra is over here on the right. And the latches are still all open. Lay the bar horizontal over the hooks. Pull it back until you feel it grab. The hooks grab the yarn, and then just bring it down and off. And then I could go ahead and use my garter bar to push that back. Thread the yarn back into the carriage. I'm going to knit 1 row across. I'm actually going to trip the tripper by hand. This way here, I don't have to reset it or move the tripper on the carriage all the time. One more time. I make sure those indents are up. Lay the bar onto the hooks. Bring the material onto the garter bar. Make sure those latches are open. Remove the stitches. Remove the yarn. Push the carriage across. Put the garter bar horizontal until I feel it grab the yarn. Bring the garter bar down and off. Rethread the carriage. Or the other thing I could do is, instead of pushing the hooks back, is I could just push the material back. This carriage will knit the stitches and work. Now, if I had the right Russell lever out, it will not, but I only had the left one out. And that's it for the garter stitch. Now I'm going to use my short piece for the standard machine, and I am just going to transfer some stitches over. I want to keep the 2 stitches plain, but the 3rd stitch on each side, I'm going to leave that needle back. Because I'm going to decrease right here in the center, and using my smaller piece here works out a lot better for me. Well, if I can get those latches open, I'm going to go down the row, make sure the rest of those are done. Now this time here I start with the needle on the left. Now I'm going to push those back, the needles back, and then I'm going to bring the stitches onto the garter bar. And it looks like I may have missed 1 or 2. Yeah, I missed 2. I'm just going to let them drop. Now it did pull out that needle there, and I do want to have these lined up as best as possible. And then I move the stitches one over so that now needle three has two stitches on it. And then I put that back on there. But before I go on, I do need to find those two stitches that did not get on the hooks. Just grab them. Luckily, it did not unravel. And put them on the hooks. So let me try the left side here. Again, I'm starting with the center needle here. And now I see I did not get a hook on the prong. And the rest of them are all there. I push the needles back with the bar. I pull the stitches onto the garter bar. And I could put this down just to open those latches. And I go one over to do that decrease. Now I could even take my weight off because I really don't need it. And I think I will because it is easier to get the stitches onto the garter bar. Some machines you do need that weight on. There's nothing you can do about that except for to keep that weight on. So now I'm going to knit across. Oh, I have to put my Russell lever back to Roman numeral 2 so it'll knit. And then I'm going to do the same. I'm going to do this for 7 rows. So I'm doing 7 decreases. Trying to make sure that I get the prong onto the hooks. But now with no weight on this, it's going to be easier if I do not get a stitch onto the prong. Now see here, I could grab in the middle and I could bring it out. Again, while I'm pushing one needle back, I'm going to lay the garter bar down and just lift it up, pull the material down, so that I could get those stitches on those hooks. I'm going to do the same over here. Now what would be nice is if I put a claw weight in the center. Well, maybe I got to put it on the waist yarn. And maybe put claw weights on the edge. So again, I'm going to decrease every row 7 times in the center of the work. After you get all the decreasing done, I'm at row 17, now I'm going to knit to row 22. And now I'm going to be doing the garter stitch again for the top of the work. So again, I need to bring my left Russell lever out. I could use my small one this time. It will fit right on here. I have to make sure that the indents are facing up. And actually, it's only one stitch off, which works out great in this case. Remove the work. Take the yarn out of the carriage. Actually, I'm going to take my tripper. Put my tripper so it will not count on me. I will manually do that. And then, like before, put the stitches back on, the needles, thread the yarn back in the carriage, knit across, do the tripper myself. So I'm going to do this, probably to row 30. I think I will work out pretty good. So just to show you one more time, pull the stitches onto the garter bar, remove the yarn out of the sinker plate, push the carriage across, put the garter bar horizontal on the needles until you feel it grab, pull it down. And if you want, push the material back. Instead of pushing the needles back, knit across and make sure you do your tripper or count the rows that you're doing. So I got to row 30. I have the purl side facing me. I'm going to do a gate peg bind off. And as I've shown before, but just to show again, you put the latched hole in the hook, you pull that hook back, you make sure the yarn goes behind the gate peg. You go into the next hook. I'm not left-handed, so okay, so I got two loops on there. I just put them back. So as I bring the needle back, the latch is behind the two loops. I grab the yarn and pull it through the two loops. Go into the next needle, pull that one back. I give a little tug on the yarn, grab the yarn in the hook, and pull it through the loops. Now, you could do whatever kind of bind off you want. It's just that this is the easiest and fastest one to do. And those without gate pegs, you're going to use your needles. And then last, all I have to do is sew up the seam, and it's ready for baby. So there it is off the machine. I would take and put the knit sides together, take the long tail, sew down the back seam, so the bottom of the foot. And this is what you get. Now for those of you that do not have a garter bar, you could do it stocking up. You're just going to have to use your prong, three-prong tool to transfer those stitches in to get those decreases. But it's only 7 rows, so it's not really an awful lot. You could take and roll down the top as it will do sometimes, or maybe try to get it up like that. Now my first attempt, I didn't have enough stitches on there. Now this will be good for a newborn or maybe a preemie, probably more of a newborn. The decreases were done every other row instead of every row. And then I tried the mock garter stitch, and I forgot to turn the work around because actually this right here is the mock garter stitch, so that doesn't really look like the garter stitch, but it helps hold that up. Again, stocking up, this is the same as this one here, just no garter stitch. The bottom beginning part of this was done the mock garter stitch too, but I forgot to turn it around. With the machines that do not, or the people that do not have a garter bar, if you want to turn it around, work off, oh, probably 4 rows of waste yarn, take it off the machine, turn the material around, rehang the stitches. But if you need to do that again, it can get monotonous. So I would not recommend doing that unless you want to for this type. I would prefer to have the garter bar to work up the garter stitch.